understand them.
You never have to come.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. أما بعد، أخذنا في الدرس الماضي ما يتعلق بشروط الحضور في الدورة وبالأسئلة التي لا بد منها قبل البدء في الدراسة.
In the name of Allah, the Most Merciful, the Bestower of Mercy, indeed all praises due to Allah, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon His Messenger. We took in the previous lesson the conditions that we all agreed upon for studying, and also some of the questions that we will ask or we ask before we begin studying the actual text.
لماذا ندرس النواقض؟
So why do we study the maxims invalidate?
ما هي النواقض؟
What are or what's the meaning of a nawaqid?
هل هي محصورة بعشر نواقض؟
Are they limited to a particular number or 10?
هل ذكر العدد في نصوص الكتاب والسنة له مفهوم أو ليس له مفهوم، أي محدد أو غير محدد؟ ولماذا يذكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أحيانا العدد وهو ليس له مفهوم؟
And does the fact that a number has been mentioned in the Quran, the Sunnah, does this always necessitate that there's a limit to those matters by that number? And also, if it doesn't necessitate a limit, then why does the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mention a number?
وكذلك ذكرنا أن بعض العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى يقول يمكن أن تحصر النواقض في أمور أربعة. نعم.
And also we mentioned that some of the scholars, may Allah mercy upon them, they've said that it's possible to limit or to enumerate those matters or summarize those matters which invalidate a person's Islam to four things.
نعم. الآن بإذن الله تعالى نبدأ بقراءة النواقض، وعلى ما اتفقنا عليه تتركوا كل شيء وتنصتوا إلى الدرس. نعم.
So now we'll begin with reading the actual text, but upon the conditions that we agreed previously, that you leave alone everything, you don't look into the text, and you listen to the reading.
نعم. بسم الله.
In English, yeah.
نعم.
So the author Muhammad ibn Abd al-Wahhab, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned at the beginning of his text, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the bestower of mercy.
نعم. بدأ المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى ببسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
So the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he began with بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, this statement, this phrase.
لماذا يبدأ العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى بالبسملة؟
Why do the scholars, may Allah the Most have mercy upon them, why do the scholars always begin by mentioning the name of Allah?
والله أعلم أن السبب في بدء العلماء رحمه الله تعالى المؤلفات بالبسملة أمور خمسة.
Allah knows best, but the reason behind which the scholars, they always begin their works by mentioning the name of Allah, there are five reasons.
اقتداء بالكتاب العزيز.
Number one, in following the guidance of the book, i.e. the Quran.
اقتداء بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في مراسلاته.
In following the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in how he used to write his letters.
اقتداء بعلماء السلف رحمهم الله تعالى.
In following the guidance of the great scholars who came previously.
تيمنا وتبركا للبداء ببسم الله، لأن كل شيء يذكر على اسم الله سبحانه وتعالى تحل فيه البركة.
And also in wanting or seeking blessing by mentioning the name of Allah, because everything which is began with the name of Allah, then in this there is some blessing.
الأمر الخامس استئناسا بحديث كل أمر ذي بال لا يبدأ فيه ببسم الله فهو أقطع. هذا الحديث يضعفه بعض العلماء، وبعض العلماء يستأنس به في البدء ببسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
And then the fifth matter is in complying with the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said كل أمر ذي بال, that every matter which has some importance to it, if it is not begun with the name of Allah, then it is maqtu', meaning the blessing in it is deficient. So even though some of the scholars have mentioned that this hadith is weak, it has some weakness in it, some others, they use this a hadith as a supporting evidence.
نعم. فإن كان حديث ضعيف يكفي الأمور التي ذكرناها قبل هذا.
So if we say that the hadith is weak, is ضعيف, then it's enough that we've mentioned the four other things.
ثم أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى ذكر هذه النواقض العشرة بقوله نعم.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned the 10 matters which invalidate a person's text by saying,
نعم.
Know that the matters which invalidate a person's Islam are 10.
نعم. وقلنا هذا من المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى فيه اتباع لهدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And we mentioned that in this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he's following the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
أراد منا أن نحفظ 10 نواقض.
So he wanted from us that we should memorize 10 matters which invalidate a person's Islam.
وإلا فالنواقض أكثر من هذه العشر.
Otherwise, the matters which invalidate a person's Islam are more than 10.
ثم بدأ المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بالناقض الأول.
And then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he began by mentioning the first matter which invalidates.
نعم فقال.
And so he said, first, الشرك. الشرك in the worship of Allah, the Most High. Allah the Most High said, indeed Allah does not forgive that partners are ascribed to him. However, he forgives anything other than that for whomsoever he wills. And the Most High said, verily, whoever sets up partners with Allah in worship, then Allah has made upon him, then Allah has made paradise forbidden upon him, and he has made the fire his abode. There will be no helpers for the oppressors. There's a mistake in the text.
نعم. الناقض الأول.
So therefore, the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam is
الشرك في عبادة الله.
Is a shirk, i.e. ascribing partners in the worship of Allah.
الشرك نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى السلام والعافية ينقسم إلى قسمين.
الشرك, and we ask Allah's safety and pardoning, it can be divided into two categories.
شرك أكبر,
a major form of shirk, شرك أكبر,
وشرك أصغر.
And شرك أصغر, a minor form of shirk.
الشرك ينقسم والله أعلم إلى قسمين, أكبر وأصغر.
So once again, a shirk, it can be divided into two categories. شرك أكبر, which is major shirk, and شرك أصغر, which is minor shirk.
قصد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بالناقض الأول بالشرك هنا أي الشرك الأكبر, لأن الشرك الأكبر مخرج من الملة.
So the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, when he mentioned الشرك here as being the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam, he intended by this الشرك الأكبر, the major form of shirk, because شرك الأكبر, major shirk, this is the type of shirk which invalidates a person's Islam or exits a person out of the fold of Islam.
كما أن التوحيد ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام, توحيد الربوبية وتوحيد الألوهية وتوحيد الأسماء والصفات, كذلك الشرك يكون في الألوهية وفي الربوبية وفي الأسماء والصفات. نعم.
So just as we say that التوحيد, it has three categories, توحيد الربوبية and توحيد الألوهية and توحيد الأسماء والصفات. نشرح بعدين. We can also say that a shirk, it can also occur in these three categories, i.e. shirk in ar-rububiyya, and shirk in uluhiyya, and shirk in al-asma wa sifat. And the Shaykh is going to explain the meaning of rububiyya, uluhiyya, and asma wa sifat, these three categories.
Tawheed ar-rububiyya huwa ifrad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bi af'alih, aw ifrad Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bil khalq wal mulki wal tadbir.
So the meaning of tawheed ar-rububiyya is singling out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his actions, meaning that you single out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he is the one who is the khaliq, the one who creates, he is the one who is the malik, the one who owns or possesses, he is the one who is the raziq, the one who provides, he is the one who is mudabbir, the one who controls all the affairs.
نعم. هذا التوحيد أي توحيد الربوبية أقر به الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, لكن لم يدخلهم هذا في الإسلام لأنهم لم يقروا بتوحيد الألوهية. نعم.
So this type of tawheed, even the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they accepted and they believed in this type of tawheed. However, their belief and their acceptance of this type of tawheed, it didn't enter them into al-Islam.
نعم. التوحيد الثاني النوع الثاني من أنواع التوحيد هو توحيد الألوهية أو توحيد العبودية أو توحيد العبادة.
So the second form of توحيد, the second category of توحيد is توحيد الألوهية. Or we can say توحيد العبودية, or we can say توحيد العبادة.
نعم. توحيد الألوهية هو إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بأفعال العباد, إفراد الله سبحانه وتعالى بالعبادة. نعم.
And the meaning of توحيد الألوهية is that you sing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is singled out in the actions of the slaves, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the singling of Allah in all acts of worship.
فمن صرف شيء قليل أو كثير من العبادة لغير الله فقد وقع في الشرك الأكبر الذي وقع فيه الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولهذا قال المؤلف الشرك في عبادة الله. نعم.
So whosoever directs any act of worship to other than Allah, then he has fallen into the major shirk. The major shirk, which is the same shirk, the polytheism or disbelief of the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For this reason, the author said that the first matter which invalidates a person Islam is shirk in the worship of Allah, i.e. in an act of worship of Allah.
على ما سيأتي معنا من أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر أنه لو ذبح لغير الله محبة وتعظيما مرة واحدة فقد وقع في الشرك الأكبر, وهذا شرك في الألوهية. نعم.
So as we're going to discuss shortly, that anybody who sacrifices an animal for other than Allah in love and ta'zim, meaning exalting the person that he's sacrificing for, then this person has fallen into a shirk al-akbar, the major form of shirk.
نعم. وسيأتي المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بأمثلة على الشرك الأكبر, وسنضيف على هذه الأمثلة بعض الأمثلة على الشرك الأكبر وكذلك على الشرك الأصغر. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى السلام والعافية. نعم.
So the author, he's going to mention some examples of shirk al-akbar, major shirk. And we'll also make some additions or mention more examples to shirk akbar, major shirk and minor shirk. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for safety and for pardoning.
نعم. فالضابط في الشرك الأكبر أنه مخرج من الملة. نعم.
And the meaning or the factor which decides something which is shirk akbar is that shirk akbar, the major form of shirk, it exits a person out of the fold of Islam.
والأصغر غير مخرج من الملة.
And as for the minor form of shirk, shirk al-asghar, then this doesn't take a person out of the fold of Islam.
الشرك الأكبر محبط لكل الأعمال.
Shirk al-akbar, major shirk, it invalidates all of the actions.
والأصغر محبط للعمل الخاص كالصلاة إذا خلطها شيء من الرياء.
And as for shirk asghar, the minor form of shirk, then this only invalidates that action in which the shirk is found. So for example, if somebody has a riyah, if somebody shows off in the prayer, then it invalidates that prayer.
صاحب الشرك الأكبر نسأل الله السلام العافية إذا مات عليه فهو مخلد خلود أبدي في النار.
And the person who has within him shirk akbar, major shirk, and we ask Allah for safety and pardoning, the person who dies upon this, then he will enter into Jahannam, into the fire, and remain therein forever.
وإذا مات نسأل الله السلام العافية على الشرك الأصغر.
And if a person dies upon shirk asghar, minor shirk,
يعذب بقدر شركه ثم يدخل الجنة.
Then he will be punished according to the level of his shirk, and then he will enter into Jannah, paradise.
الأكبر مبيح للدم والمال.
And shirk al-akbar, the major form of shirk, it makes a person's wealth and a person's blood and wealth permitted to take.
لكن هذا من السلطان.
However, this is according to the or is under the command of the ruler.
إما أن تتكلم أو نتكلم.
Either you speak or we speak.
من يتكلم فينا؟
Who should be speaking?
نعم. الشرك الأكبر مبيح للدم والمال من السلطان. نعم.
So the major form of shirk, shirk akbar, the ruler, this Muslim ruler, it is permitted for him to take a person's wealth and a person's blood due to shirk akbar.
على ما سيأتي بإذن الله تعالى في حكم المرتد.
And we're going to mention this when it comes to the ruling of the infidel or the apostate, a person who leaves Islam.
والأصغر غير مبيح للدم والمال.
And as for shirk asghar, then this doesn't permit for blood or wealth to be taken.
كل ما كان وسيلة إلى الأكبر فهو أصغر.
And everything which is an avenue towards major shirk, then this is minor shirk.
أن ينص عليه إذا جاء في الكتاب والسنة النص عليه أنه أكبر فهو أكبر وإذا جاء النص عليه أنه أصغر فهو أصغر كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الشرك الأصغر في الرياء. نعم.
And also
أخاف ما أخاف عليكم الشرك الأصغر فسأل عنه فقال الرياء.
And also that anything which the Quran, the Sunnah says is shirk akbar and names it shirk akbar or classifies it as being shirk akbar, then this is shirk akbar. And anything which the Quran, the Sunnah classifies as being shirk asghar, minor shirk, then it is shirk asghar. Like in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said,
"أخوف ما أخاف عليكم الشرك الأصغر."
Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "أخوف ما أخاف عليكم." That the most, the thing which I fear upon you the most is a minor shirk, shirk asghar. And then he was asked about minor shirk, what is minor shirk, and he said, "الرياء, showing off."
إذا اعتقد أن لهذا تصرف خفي في الكون أو بيد جلب المنافع ودفع المضار فهذا شرك أكبر.
So if a person believes that another person has any control in the affairs of the universe or the affairs of the world, then this becomes shirk أكبر, major form of shirk.
وإذا جعل شيء من الأسباب التي لم يجعلها الله سبحانه وتعالى أسباب واعتقد أن سبب الله سبحانه وتعالى لم يجعلها سبب فهذا شرك أصغر.
If however a person believes that a particular cause is a cause that Allah has placed,
كما يعتقد مثلا أن رأس الثور سبب في دفع الشياطين مثلا.
So for example, if somebody believes that a particular matter is a cause for something to happen, and Allah has made this a cause for it to happen, and yet in reality, Allah didn't make this a cause for something to happen. An example of this is to make it clear that some people believe that the head of a bull, if you place it above your house, then this is protection for you from shaitan, for example.
قال الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى.
Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, he said,
كل ما أطلق الشرع عليه أنه شرك أو كفر ولم يعرف بأل فالأصل أنه أصغر.
That everything which is mentioned in the Sharia or mentioned by Allah as being shirk, like that in a general manner, or as being kufr, disbelief, then relates to shirk akbar, a major form of disbelief or major form of shirk.
بين الرجل وبين الشرك والكفر هذا أكبر لأنه عرف بأل بين الرجل وبين الشرك والكفر معرف بأل هنا الشرك والكفر فهذا أكبر.
So for example, it is said that the hadith,
no.
Like the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that between a man and a shirk with alif lam, and he defined this shirk, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said between a man and the disbelief, and he said the, and he defined it. This therefore relates to shirk and kufr akbar.
قال عليه الصلاة والسلام اثنتان في الناس هما بهم كفر.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that two characteristics are found amongst the people and they are disbelief.
هنا الكفر لم يعرف بأل فهو أصغر.
But here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't say al-kufr, it is the disbelief, he just said kufr, it is disbelief generally, and therefore this is minor kufr, minor disbelief.
هذا في الأصل ما لم يدل دليل على أنه أكبر. أي أراد هنا الكفر الأكبر للأصغر. نعم.
So this is in anything in which there isn't an evidence found saying this is kufr akbar or kufr asghar.
هذه فروق ذكرها العلماء رحمهم الله تعالى بين الشرك الأكبر والشرك الأصغر.
So these matters which the Sheikh has just mentioned, these are factors which differentiates between something being shirk akbar or shirk asghar.
على أي اعتبار لابد أن نحذر من الشرك سواء كان أكبر أو أصغر لأننا ذكرنا أن الأصغر يؤدي إلى الشرك الأكبر نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى السلامة والعافية.
And anyway, in all cases, whatever the type of shirk, then we have to stay away from it, whether it's shirk akbar or shirk asghar, because we have mentioned that often shirk asghar will lead to shirk akbar. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for safety and pardoning.
نعم. ثم أن المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى استدل بقوله سبحانه وتعالى إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به. نعم.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he used as an evidence the saying of Allah the Most High, indeed Allah does not forgive that partners are described to him. Or ascribed to him, sorry.
نعم. وهذا ما ذكرناه. أنه إذا مات نسأل الله السلام عافية على الشرك الأكبر فهو مخلد خلود أبدي في النار.
And this is, as we have mentioned, that anybody who dies upon shirk akbar, anybody who dies upon the major form of shirk, then this person will enter into the fire and remain in it forever.
وإذا مات نسأل الله السلامة عافية على الشرك الأصغر يعذب بقدر هذا الشرك ثم يدخل الجنة.
If however somebody dies upon shirk asghar, a minor form of shirk, نسأل الله السلامة والعافية, then the person will be punished according to the level or extent of his shirk.
واغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء.
And then Allah says in this ayah, however he forgives other than that.
أي من الكبائر والصغائر.
So he forgives the other sins, major sins and minor sins.
لأن المراتب أربعة.
Because the level of sins are four.
محرمات.
Sorry, the levels of those things which are haram are four.
صغائر.
Minor.
وأعلى من الصغائر كبائر.
A minor sin, and then something which is more than a minor sin, a major sin.
وأعلى من الكبائر شرك أصغر.
And then something which is more severe than the major sin, which is a shirk al-asghar, the minor form of shirk.
وأعلى من الشرك الأصغر الشرك الأكبر.
And then something which is higher than the minor form of shirk, I shirk akbar. Just to repeat one more time, a minor sin, and then something which is more severe, a major sin, and then something which is more severe, a minor level of shirk or minor form of shirk, and then something which is more severe, major shirk. These are the four levels of those things which are haram.
نعم. ثم ذكر قول الله تعالى إنهم يشرك بالله. وهذا الذي ذكرنا أن المشرك شرك أكبر نسأل الله السلامة العافية مخلد في النار خلود أبدي. أما المشرك شرك أصغر يعذب بقدر شركه ثم يدخل الجنة, أي لا يدخل الجنة ابتداء. نعم.
So then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned the second ayah where he said إنه من يشرك بالله, indeed he who ascribes partners to Allah in worship, فقد حرم الله عليه الجنة, then he has made paradise forbidden for him, haram for him, وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ, and his final abode is the hellfire. So that the one who commits shirk akbar, the major shirk, that he will enter to the fire and remain forever. As for the one who commits shirk asghar, then he will enter into fire first. So he won't go into paradise first. He's going to Jahannam first and be punished according to the level of his minor shirk and then enter into Jannah.
طيب إذا تاب من الشرك الأكبر أو من الشرك الأصغر في وقت تقبل في التوبة, هل تقبل منه التوبة أم لا؟
Okay, so if a person he repents from the major form of shirk or the minor form of shirk in a time in which the repentance is accepted, is his repentance from major shirk or minor shirk accepted or not?
هل إذا تاب من الشرك سواء كان أكبر أو أصغر في وقت تقبل في التوبة, هل تقبل منه التوبة أو لا؟
So once again,
من يعرف؟
So once again, if a person repents from major shirk or minor shirk in a time in which the repentance is accepted, then is his repentance from major shirk accepted or not? Who knows?
نعم. نعم. والدليل قول الله تعالى قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا. نعم.
And the answer is yes, as the brother mentioned, and the evidence of this is the saying of Allah, قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا, say, O my slaves who have exceeded the limits of sins, that do not become despondent or do not lose hope from the mercy of Allah, for Allah forgives all of the sins.
نعم. ثم بدأ المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى بذكر أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر حتى نحذر منها. نعم.
And then the author, after this, may Allah have mercy upon him, he began by mentioning examples of shirk akbar so we can be careful of them and stay away from them.
نعم.
So he said, included in this, shirk akbar, is sacrificing for other than Allah, such as a person sacrificing for a jinn or sacrificing towards a grave.
الذبح لغير الله محبة وتعظيما. الذبح لغير الله محبة وتعظيما شرك أكبر.
So, an animal which is sacrificed for other than Allah out of love and out of exalting that person or that thing for which this animal was sacrificed for, this is shirk akbar, major form of shirk.
لأن الذبح عندنا ينقسم إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
Because sacrificing an animal is of three types of sacrifices.
ذبح لله,
a sacrifice which is done for the sake of Allah.
وهذا عبادة.
And this is worship.
الهدي والأضاحي.
Such
والصدقات.
نعم. Such as charity or the ritual form of sacrificing that takes place after Eid al-Adha or in Hajj, and this is all a form of worship.
والذبح لغير الله محبة وتعظيمة شرك أكبر.
And then the second type is a sacrificing or sacrificing an animal for other than the sake of Allah, محبة out of love and تعظيمة out of exalting that person, and this is shirk akbar.
كذبح الجن.
Like for example, sacrificing for a jinn.
أو لأصحاب القبور.
Or sacrificing for somebody in a grave.
على ما مثل المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى.
Like the example that the author, may Allah mercy upon him, gave.
القسم الثالث من الذبح ذبح جائز.
And then the third type of sacrificing is the sacrificing the ذبح which is permissible.
يذبح حتى يأكل من هذه الذبيحة.
So for example, a person sacrifices an animal so he can eat from it.
أو يبيع اللحوم فيذبح حتى يبيع هذه اللحوم فهذا جائز.
Or for example, somebody who sells meat and therefore he sacrifices an animal in order to sell the meat, and this is permissible.
نعم. المثال الثاني الذي ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى في التمثيل على الشرك الأكبر. نعم. نعم.
النقض الثاني.
لا نريد أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر.
So we want examples of shirk akbar, major forms of shirk.
الذبح لغير الله محبة وتعظيمة.
We mentioned sacrificing for other than Allah out of love and exalting.
غير من الأمثلة. من يذكر لي؟
Who can mention other examples of shirk akbar?
أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر.
Examples of major shirk.
نعم.
من سجد لغير
صرف شيء من العبادة لغير الله يشمل الصلاة والصيام والحج والزكاة وكل العبادات. نعم. نعم.
So the brother mentioned, may Allah bless him, that prostrating to other than Allah. And the Shaykh said that directing any form of worship, any act of worship to other than Allah, then this is shirk akbar. And this includes a prayer, this includes any type of act of worship.
نعم. ومنه الذبح لغير الله.
And from amongst them is sacrificing for other than Allah.
النذر لغير الله.
Taking a vow by other than Allah.
الخوف من غير الله.
And having الخوف fear from other than Allah.
دعاء العبادة على ما ذكر.
And a supplication or a supplication which is worship as is, has been mentioned.
دعاء المسألة فيما لا يقدر عليه إلا الله. يطلب مثلا من غير الله إنزال الغيث أو الرزق أو طلب الولد مثلا. نعم.
Or requesting from somebody something that person doesn't have the ability to give. So for example, somebody requests from somebody for the rain to descend or for a child to be given.
نعم. نريد كذلك أمثلة على الشرك الأصغر.
And also we want examples of شرك أصغر, minor شرك.
نعم. من يعرف مثال على الشرك الأصغر.
Who knows an example of شرك أصغر؟
نعم. الرياء على ما سماه النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام شرك أصغر. أو على ما ذكر ابن القيم يسير الرياء. هذا فيه أن ابن القيم يرى أن كثير الرياء نسأل الله السلام العافية مشرك شرك أكبر. نعم.
So the brother mentioned, may Allah bless him, that an example of شرك أصغر, minor شرك, is الرياء, showing off. Like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned, that in the hadith that the Sheikh mentioned earlier, when he said the most serious thing that I fear upon you is shirk al-asghar, and the companion asked, what is shirk al-asghar? And he said, al-riya, showing off. However, the Shaykh mentioned that Ibn al-Qayyim rahimullah, he mentioned that shirk asghar is only a little bit of riya, because Ibn al-Qayyim, may Allah have mercy upon him, he considers a person having a lot of riya, a lot of showing off, to be shirk akbar, somebody who is a mushrik.
كذلك الحلف بغير الله الأصل فيه أنه شرك أصغر.
And also taking a vow by other than Allah, the base ruling here that it is shirk أصغر.
نعم. وكذلك قول ما شاء الله وشئت.
And also a person saying whatever Allah willed and whatever you will.
هذا من الشرك الأصغر.
And this is from a minor form of shirk.
نعم. بهذا انتهينا ولله الحمد من الناقض الأول من نواقض الإسلام.
And by mentioning this, we are finished from the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam.
من يذكر لي ما أخذنا في هذا الناقض.
So who can now mention the things which we have taken or studied regarding this first matter which invalidates a person's Islam?
نعم.
نعم.
البقية لم يحضروا معنا.
The rest of you weren't present here.
اتفقنا على المشاركة.
We have agreed that all of us have to take part.
نعم.
Started by mentioning the Okay. Five things, for example, of this topic. So, for example, we follow the Quran, the Sunnah, the Salaf.
Allah iftah alayk. Now,
so the brother mentioned, may Allah bless him, that why we should start off with Bismillah, the five matters.
نعم قلنا سبب البدء بالبسملة. لماذا يبدأ علماء أهل السنة والجماعة بالبسملة في مؤلفاتهم؟
So we said that why do the scholars always begin their works or their writings with mention the name of Allah, and we said five matters, the five reasons.
بالكتاب العزيز.
Following the guidance of the book, the Quran.
وبالنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Following the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وعلماء السلف.
And following the guidance of the great scholars of the previous generations.
تيمن وتبرك البدع بسم الله.
And also in seeking blessings by beginning with the name of Allah.
استئناسا بالحديث وإن كان لا يصح.
And also using the hadith, and the Shaykh said استئناسا, meaning using the hadith only as a supporting evidence, not as an evidence itself, even though some of the scholars said that the hadith is weak.
ما هو الناقض الأول?
So what is the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam?
هذا أمر واضح.
This is something which is very clear.
نعم. الشرك في عبادة الله فتح الله عليك. نعم.
الشرك in the worship of Allah, may Allah bless you.
أي الشرك الأكبر والأصغر أو الشرك الأكبر والأصغر.
Does this refer to shirk أكبر and أو أصغر or both of them?
ثلاث اختيارات.
So you've got three choices.
الشرك الأكبر.
Either the major form of shirk.
أو الشرك الأصغر.
Or the minor form of shirk.
أو الشرك الأكبر والأصغر.
Or both shirk أكبر and أصغر.
ماذا أراد المؤلف هنا بالناقض في قوله الشرك في عبادة الله?
What did the author intend when he said that the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam is a shirk? Which one of these three choices?
نعم. الشرك الأكبر. فتح الله عليك.
الشرك الأكبر.
نعم. إذا قصد المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى هنا الشرك الأصغر، مع أننا ذكرنا أن لا بد على الموحد أن يحذر من الشرك سواء كان أكبر أو أصغر، لأن الأصغر يؤدي للأكبر. نعم.
قصد المؤلف الشرك الأكبر.
نعم. قصد المؤلف الشرك الأكبر.
So like we mentioned that the author here, may Allah merciful upon him, he intended by the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam is shirk akbar, major shirk. However, we mention as Muslims, we have to be careful of and be cautious of both forms of shirk. Shirk akbar and shirk asghar.
أنواع الشرك كم?
What are the types of shirk?
نعم, ذكرنا.
We just mentioned, what are the types of shirk?
ما هي أنواع الشرك, نعم. أكبر, فتح الله عليك, نعم.
As the young brother mentioned, shirk akbar, major form of shirk, and minor shirk.
ما هو الفرق بين الشرك الأكبر والشرك الأصغر?
So what is the difference between shirk akbar and shirk asghar?
نعم. الأكبر
الأكبر يخرج
مخرج من الملة, والأصغر غير مخرج من الملة.
So, as the brother mentioned, that shirk akbar, the major form of shirk, it exits a person out of the fold of Islam, and shirk asghar, minor shirk, it doesn't exit the person out of the fold of Islam.
نعم. الثاني, الأكبر محبط لجميع الأعمال.
Secondly, that shirk akbar invalidates all of the actions.
الأصغر محبط للعمل الخاص.
And as for shirk asghar, it only invalidates that particular action.
مبيح للدم والمال.
That shirk akbar, it makes a person's blood and wealth permissible.
غير مبيح للدم والمال من السلطان.
And as for shirk asghar, then it's not the case with shirk asghar, and this refers to the right of the ruler, the Muslim ruler.
Al-akbar mukhallad fi an-nar khulud abadi, nasallahu salama afiya. Wal-asghar ghayr mukhallad khulud abadi.
And the person who has shirk akbar, then this person enters into the fire forever, and we ask Allah for safety and pardoning. However, the person who has shirk asghar, minor shirk, he doesn't enter forever into hell.
أن ينص عليه في نصوص الكتاب والسنة أنه أكبر أو أصغر.
Or that in the Quran, the Sunnah, we find a text stating that this is shirk akbar, this is shirk asghar.
إذا اعتقد أن له تصرف خلف الكون وإذا جلب المنافع دفع المضار فهذا أكبر.
If a person believes that this person he has any say or any control over the affairs of the world or changing of the world, if a person believes that this person he himself can bring out some good, or he himself can repel some harm, all of this comes under shirk akbar.
إذا أثبت أو إذا اعتقد أنه سبب الله سبحانه وتعالى لم يجعله سبب فهذا أصغر.
And if a person believes for something to be a cause for something to happen, and yet Allah hasn't made it a cause for something to happen,
كل ما كان وسيلة الأكبر فهو أصغر.
And then this is shirk asghar. And then everything which is an avenue towards shirk akbar, everything, every action which leads to shirk akbar is shirk asghar.
كل ما أطلق الشرع عليه أنه شرك أو كفر ولم يعرف بألف فهو أصغر.
And every matter that the Sharia has said that this is shirk or kufr, but he didn't. But in the Sharia, it isn't mentioned al either shirk, or hasn't specified it or made it definite. Then this is a minor form of shirk.
نعم وإذا عرف بألف فهو أكبر.
If, however, that term that this is shirk is meant as ash-shirk, i.e. with alif lam, has been defined, then this is shirk akbar.
ما حكم من صرف شيء من العبادة لغير الله؟
What is the ruling of the person who directs any act of worship to other than Allah?
نعم. مشرك شرك أكبر. نعم.
That this person is a mushrik who has shirk akbar. Major form of shirk.
نعم. نريد أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر.
So we want examples for the major form of shirk.
نعم. أمثلة على الشرك الأكبر.
Major forms of shirk. Examples of the major form of shirk. الذبح.
الذبح لغير الله لكن بضابط. قلنا قد يذبح حتى يأكل أو يذبح حتى يبيع هذا اللحم. هذا ذبح جائز. الذبح لغير الله محبة وتعظيم أو الذبح للجن ولأصحاب القبور. نعم.
So the brother mentioned sacrificing, and the Shaykh said, we say sacrificing for other than the sake of Allah with conditions or with restrictive factors, and that is that sacrificing for other than Allah out of love and out of exalting. If, however, a person sacrifices in order he can eat, or if a person sacrifices so he can sell the meat, then this is permissible. And the Shaykh mentioned that another example of sacrificing for other than the sake of Allah, which is Shirk Akbar, is a person sacrificing for a jinn, a person sacrificing for a person who is in the grave.
Dua al-ibadah.
And also we mentioned Dua al-ibadah.
Shirk Akbar.
Which is Shirk Akbar.
Dua al-mas'ala fi ma la qadir alayhi illallah.
And also requesting something from somebody who doesn't have the ability to give you that thing. This is also Shirk Akbar.
كطلب الولد مثلا أو إنزال الغيث.
So for example, a person requesting for rain to be sent from a person or requesting a child from a person.
وأخذنا كذلك أمثلة على الشرك الأصغر الرياء.
And we took examples, and we also took examples of minor shirks such as showing off.
والحلف بغير الله.
And taking a vow by other than Allah.
وقول ما شاء الله وشئت.
And saying whatever Allah wills and you will.
نعم. الناقض الثاني.
Yes, the second matter which invalidates a person's Islam. The author Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimullah mentioned, second, whoever sets up intermediaries between himself and Allah, supplicating to them, requesting intercession from them, and relying upon them, such a person has disbelieved by ijma, i.e. according to the consensus or the agreement of the scholars.
نعم. ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى في الناقض الثاني ما وقع فيه الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So in this second matter which the author mentioned, he mentioned the action or the shirk which the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that they fell into.
وهذا من حسن الترتيب في النواقض عند المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى. في الناقض الأول ذكر الشرك في عبادة الله.
So this is, or this shows the ability of the author in terms of how he sets out these matters which invalidate a person in Islam. So the first thing that he mentioned was a shirk in worship.
نعم لأنه قد يقول لك هذا الذي قد أتى نسأل الله السلام عافية بناقض وناقض الإسلام قد يقول لك أنا لا أعبد هؤلاء أريد منهم القربة والشفاعة.
Because a person who falls into this type of shirk, i.e. making wasa'it, intermediaries or shafa'a, intercession, a person might say that, look, I don't worship those things that I'm directing this act of worship. I'm not worshipping them, but I only direct these actions to them so they can take me closer to Allah. I only direct these acts to them so they can intercede for me on behalf of Allah.
نعم ونتلو على الآيات في أن هذا هو قول الكفار وبهذا كفرهم الله سبحانه وتعالى ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفى هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله.
And this person says this, we recite upon him the verses of the ayat which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned regarding the disbelief of the mushrikeen at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that this is what they used to say. And yet despite them saying this, using this doubt and this argument, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still call them disbelievers. For example, the saying of Allah that Allah said, وما نعبدهم
ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا الله زلفى.
ما نعبدهم, that we don't really worship these objects except that they should take us close to Allah. والآية الثانية
هؤلاء شفعاءنا عند الله.
And that the mushrikeen at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they say that these objects, they're only forms of intercession to Allah.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا ذكر ما تعلق بالتوكل.
And then after this, the author, he mentioned that which relates to التوكل, I reliance.
التوكل الذي صرف لغير الله هو الشرك أكبر, هو الاعتماد مطلق وتفويض جميع أموره إليه واعتقاد أن بيدي جلب المنافع دفع المضر, هذا صرف لغير الله شرك أكبر. لا بد من الاعتماد المطلق على الله سبحانه وتعالى واعتقاد أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو الذي بيدي جلب المنافع ودفع المضار. من اعتمد اعتماد مطلق على غير الله في كل أحواله, نعم, واعتقد أن بيدي جلب المنافع ودفع المضار, فهذا مشرك شرك أكبر. في أي باب؟ في باب التوكل, وعلى الله فتوكلوا. نعم.
So the author mentioned, he mentioned التوكل, reliance, and that this can also be a form of shirk. And the Shaykh said that the form of tawakkul, reliance, which is shirk, is for somebody to totally rely on something else besides Allah.
اعتماد مطلق في كل أموره.
I person in all of his affairs, he relies on other than Allah.
واعتقاد أن بيدي جلب المنافع ودفع المضار.
And that he believes that this person or this thing, it can bring about some good or it can repel some evil.
نعم. والتوكل يعرف بأنه صدق الاعتماد على الله سبحانه وتعالى مع الثقة به والأخذ بالأسباب المشروعة, ثلاث أشياء. صدق الاعتماد على الله.
So التوكل, reliance, it can be defined as something which compromises of three things. Number one, صدق الاعتماد على الله, that somebody truly relies on Allah
مع الثقة به,
and at the same time trusting him, having trust in him,
أي أن يثق أن الله سبحانه وتعالى منجز له هذا. نعم, لا محالة.
And meaning that a person has complete trust in Allah, that Allah will bring this thing for him. And this isn't impossible.
والأخذ بالأسباب المشروعة على الممنوعة.
And then the third matter which comes under true reliance is using those avenues or those causes which Allah has placed upon this earth.
مثاله.
So an example of this is,
هذا الأخ,
this brother,
يريد أن يحفظ القرآن.
This brother, he wants to memorize the Quran.
وقال أنا متوكل على الله.
And he says that I am somebody who relies upon Allah.
وكان صادق في هذا الكلام, لا كاذب.
And he's truthful in this speech, in this statement. He's not lying.
وفي قرارة نفسه واثق أن الله سبحانه وتعالى ميسر له حفظ القرآن لا محالة.
And inside him, deep inside him, he knows and he believes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the memorization of the Quran easy for him. And this is impossible.
ثم أخذ بالأسباب المشروعة, في كل يوم يحفظ ويراجع ويعرض المصحف على شيخ متقن. نعم.
And then after this, he then starts using those causes or those avenues which Allah has placed, meaning he memorizes every single day and he revises every single day and he reads to a sheikh who is proficient in his memorization or his recitation.
نعم, هذا هو الناقض الثاني من نواقض الإسلام.
So this is the second matter from amongst the matters which invalidates a person's Islam.
من يعيد لي ما ذكرنا في هذا الناقض أو شيء مما ذكرنا في هذا الناقض؟
So who can repeat that which has been mentioned regarding this matter which invalidates a person's Islam or anything, any benefit that we have mentioned regarding this?
نعم.
Any benefit?
نعم. من يعرف أخوان؟
Who knows? Any benefit that the Sheikh mentioned?
نعم.
Setting up intermediary. Setting up intermediary between himself and Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. This is.
جعل الوصاية.
قلنا أن المؤلف رتب. ذكر العبادة وبعد العبادة ذكر طلب القربة والشفاعة.
We mentioned that.
لأنه قد يقول أنه لا يعبد هؤلاء, يريد منهم فقط القربة والشفاعة. نعم.
So we mentioned that the author, he brought this in sequence. First he said that the first matter which invalidates is shirk in worship, worshipping something other besides Allah. And then the second thing he mentioned was that making somebody as an intermediary or an intercession, a shafa'a, between him and Allah. Because this person might say that I'm not really worshipping that object, but I'm just directing this action to them or to it, so it can bring me closer to Allah. Or because it can be an intercession for me in front of Allah.
نعم. فطلب القربة طلب الشفاعة هو فعل الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وكفرهم الله.
So directing an act of worship to something else and then saying that it only is I'm only doing this so it brings me close to Allah, or because it's an intercession for a شفاعة between Allah, then this is the action of the mushrikeen at the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And for this Allah سبحانه وتعالى declare them as being disbelievers.
نعم. غير هذا مما ذكر.
Any other benefit that we mentioned.
هذا الناقض الثاني من نواقض الإسلام.
Any other benefit that we mentioned regarding the second matter which invalidates the person of
Islam. طلب القربة والشفاعة و نعم التوكل أي اعتماد مطلق وتفويض جميع أموره إليه واعتقاد أن بيده جلب المنافع ودفع المضار صرف لغير الله شرك أكبر أصغر أكبر نعم.
So, as the brother mentioned, may Allah bless him, that the other benefit that the Shaykh mentions regarding at-tawakkul, meaning somebody completely placing their trust and their reliance in other than Allah, in an absolute sense, and believing that this other thing besides Allah, he or she in itself can bring about some good, or he can repel some evil. And this, believing this, is shirk akbar.
Now, هذا ما يتعلق والله أعلم بالناقض الثاني, وذكرنا أيضا تعريف التوكل هو صدق الاعتماد على الله سبحانه وتعالى مع الثقة به والأخذ بالأسباب المشروعة للممنوعة.
So this is what we mentioned regarding the second matter which invalidates a person's Islam. We also mentioned the definition of true reliance, and that is something which compromises of three things: صدق الاعتماد على الله, i.e. true reliance, being truthful in your reliance in Allah, مع الثقة به, and having trust, complete trust in him, and at the same time, أخذ الأسباب المشروع. At the same time, using those means, those causes which Allah has placed and legislated.
إذن طلب القربة ما نعبدهم إلا ليقربونا إلى الله زلفا.
Therefore, once again, directing an act of worship because you believe that you want this person to take you closer to Allah. This is what the mushrikun said as a saying of Allah, that we don't really worship them. When Allah was talking about the mushrikeen at the time of the Prophet, we don't really worship them except that they take us closer to Allah.
طلب الشفاعة فيما لا يقدر عليه إلا الله.
And then seeking intercession from this person.
فهذا الشرك أكبر.
And this is also major form of shirk.
كذلك التوكل على غير الله. اعتماد مطلق.
And also completely relying upon other than Allah.
نعم.
Yes.
هل يصح أن يقول توكلت على فلان؟
Is it permissible for a person to say that I relied upon somebody from amongst the people?
لا.
No.
أبدا.
Never.
ولا يصح أيضا أن يقول توكلت على الله ثم على فلان. لا يصح.
And it's not even permissible for a person to say that I have reliance upon Allah and then upon somebody else.
من باب أولى أنه لا يصح أن يقول توكلت على الله ثم على فلان.
Rather,
يقول توكلت على الله فقط. نعم.
Rather, person should only say, I had my reliance in Allah.
نعم. ثم ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله تعالى الناقض الثالث من نواقض الإسلام. صلى الله العافية.
And نعم. Then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned the third matter which invalidates a person's Islam. We ask Allah's safety and pardoning.
نعم.
He said, the third matter is a person who does not consider the mushrikun, the polytheists, to be disbelievers, or has shak or doubts their disbelief, or considers their madhab, their ideology, or their way to be correct. Such a person has disbelieved.
نعم. هذا الناقض يتضح في لا إله إلا الله.
So this third matter which invalidates a person's Islam, this is very clear in the statement لا إله إلا الله.
لأننا عندما نقول أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبد رسوله, معنى شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله أي لا معبود بحق إلا الله, نثبت العبادة لله وحده لا شريك له, وننفي جميع ما يعبد من دون الله. نعم. قال
نعم. أعيد الكلام. Because we said that this third matter which invalidates the person on which the author has mentioned, this is very clear in our statement, La ilaha illallah. Because the meaning of Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, that I testify or I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship in truth except Allah, this compromises of somebody affirming worship for Allah and at the same time rejecting and disbelieving everything which is worship besides Allah.
La ilaha nafiyan jami' ma'bud min dunillah.
So la ilaha meaning there is no deity, meaning negating all other false deities, all other false gods or false objects which are worshipped besides Allah, a negation.
Illallah muthbitan ibadah Allah wahdahu la sharika lah.
Except Allah, illallah, meaning that you affirm and you accept that all types and forms of worship have to be made for Allah alone. He has no partners.
La ilaha.
La ilaha, there is no deity.
La ma'buda bihaq.
Meaning, la ma'buda bihaq, meaning that there is no object and no deity and no God worthy of worship in truth. Meaning, everything which is worshipped besides Allah, then that worship is false and invalid and not accepted. So therefore, when we say the shahada, when we say the testimony, la ilaha illallah, we have to have two pillars.
Kufr bil-taghut qabla al-iman billah.
Firstly, disbelieving in all of the false deities, and this is before affirming the worship for Allah.
وهذه حقيقة التوحيد.
And this is the true essence of التوحيد.
أن تجمع بين النفي والإثبات.
That you accept both the negation and the affirmation.
الكفر بالطاغوت ثم بعد هذا الإيمان بالله.
Firstly, rejecting and disbelieving in all of the false deities, and then affirming worship for Allah.
فمن شك.
So whomsoever doubts,
أو توقف,
or he doesn't take a position,
أو تردد,
or he is unsure,
أو قال أنا لا أكفر هؤلاء,
or a person says that I don't consider them to be disbelievers,
فقد أتى بناقض من نواقض الإسلام,
then this person, he has fallen into a matter which invalidates a person's Islam.
هل اليهود والنصارى,
the Jews and the Christians,
أهل الكتاب,
the people of the book,
الذين بلغتهم دعوة محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Those people to whom the da'wah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was conveyed.
ولم يدخلوا في الإسلام.
And yet they did not enter into Islam.
هل هم كفار أم لا؟
Are they disbelievers or not?
كفار ولا شك في كفرهم.
They're disbelievers and there's no doubt in this.
ومن شك في كفرهم فهو كافر مثلهم.
And whomsoever doubts they disbelieve, then he is a disbeliever like them.
ما الدليل؟
What's the evidence for this?
قال عليه الصلاة والسلام.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said,
والذي نفسي بيده,
that I take an oath by the one in whose hand is my soul.
أقسم عليه الصلاة والسلام وهو صادق بلا قسم.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he took an oath and a vow and he's truthful in this.
لكن حتى يؤكد هذا الأمر.
So even though he tells the truth without taking a vow or an oath, he took an oath or a vow just to emphasize this matter.
لا يسمع بي يهودي.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that a Jew does not hear of me,
ولا نصراني,
nor a Christian,
ثم لا يؤمن بي,
and then he does not believe in me,
إلا كان من أهل النار,
except that he is from the people of the fire.
قال الله تعالى,
Allah the Most High said,
قاتل الذين لا يؤمنون بالله ولا باليوم الآخر,
fight those people who do not believe in Allah in the final day,
ولا يحرمون ما حرم الله ورسوله,
and they do not make impermissible that which Allah and His Messenger has made impermissible,
ولا يدينون دين الحق,
and they do not hold the true religion to be the truth.
وغير الحق الباطل.
And the opposite of truth is falsehood.
من الذين أوتوا الكتاب أي أهل الكتاب.
From the people who are given the book, I the people of the book.
وغير هذا من الأدلة.
And other evidences that mention this.
إذن.
Therefore.
من صحح مذهب أهل الكتاب أي بعد بعثة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So a person who holds the ideology or the way of the people of the book to be correct, i.e. after the coming of the Prophet ﷺ.
أو شك.
Or he doubts.
أو توقف.
Or he doesn't take a position, he stops.
أو تردد.
Or he's unsure.
أو قال أنا لا أذكر فيهم شيء. لا إيمان ولا كفر.
Or he says that I'm not going to say that they're believers or that they're disbelievers.
فقد وافق الكفار نسأل الله السلام العافية في كفرهم.
Then this person has agreed with the disbelievers in their disbelief.
وذكرنا لكم ما يتعلق بالأدلة، والله أعلم، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. بعد صلاة المغرب إن شاء الله تعالى نكمل.